August 4, 2020. A deadly explosion occurred shortly after 6 o'clock in the evening at Beirut, capital city of Lebanon, known as the Paris of Middle East at the Mediterranean coast. At a warehouse in the port, more than 2,750 tons of ammonium nitrate, which is equivalent to 1.1 kilotons of TNT, was stored without proper safety measures. The chemicals, when contaminated, act as dangerous explosives along with fireworks and tires, which was also stored at the warehouse. The fire broke out around 5:45 p.m. local time, and the explosion occurred at 6:08 p.m. local time. Strong explosions are believed to not only damage the nearby solid structures around, but also they cause massive damage to the upper atmosphere. The blast was also visible from faraway distances as it released a huge spherical wave to the atmosphere and a mushroom-shaped cloud of smokes, which was around 800 meters high, considered as one of the most powerful non-nuclear explosions in human history. This explosion not only damaged the port area, but also the whole city from the radiating shockwave. It was a calm evening when people were offering prayers in the churches or relishing the lovely atmosphere of the city. The sudden explosion caused chairs all over the city. The shockwave gave people a little or no time to respond to the shake. Everything was shattered. There was a moment of darkness and silence. The explosion was so massive that the United States of Geological Survey registered it as a 3.3 magnitude event. The explosion sent a massive mushroom cloud into the air and a supersonic shockwave radiating throughout the city, which was also recorded in Tunisia and Germany. Seismic stations within 500 kilometers captured seismic waves. The blast extensively destroyed the immediate dockside area as well as greater portions of the city. The home to nearly 2 million residents, scarred by civil war, suffered an impact of nearly 200 deaths, 6,500 injuries, more than 200,000 temporarily homeless people. The gorgeous buildings and hotels at the tourist-friendly port received most of the damage. Already baffled by the pandemic, the country gained a collective property damage of about $10 to $15 billion. The explosion left the port with a crater of approximately 140 meters in diameter, as scars which flooded with seawater. The disaster created history as one of the greatest sufferings to the mankind. However, as a flip side of every coin, the explosion was also an example of massive above-ground high-energy explosion for science. This gave an opportunity to the researchers to investigate the damages caused to the atmosphere and compare it with the properties of the past cases of explosion. The array of GPS networks provide insights to the effects on atmosphere due to the explosion. The GPS, with the help of satellites, can give information about atmosphere as well as surface activities. This enabled the researchers to observe ionospheric total electron content, known as TC. The ionosphere is a layer of charged particles surrounding the Earth at around 50 to 1,000 kilometers of distance from the surface. The charged particles gain energy from the UV rays, and the density shows response to both space and surface activities. The layer also acts as a scientific benefit as it helps in communication through the movement of microwaves to and fro. We had the great sights of aurora, reflecting plane for the communication waves. Observation of changes due to atmospheric disturbances, the ionosphere is the platform to learn. The explosion radiated microwaves, which traveled to the ionosphere undergoing frequency-dependent delay. Satellites transmit microwave signals in multiple frequencies in L-band. This enabled to isolate ionospheric information by making the phase difference between the two carrier waves, creating a time series of TEC for various ionospheric disturbances. The vertical TEC time series obtained from ground stations of GNSS satellites in Israel and Palestine at south of Beirut show clear ane-shaped disturbances emerge 10 to 12 minutes after the explosion. However, such clear signals are either missing or ambiguous at stations far to the north, like in Turkey and Cyprus. Although a neutral atmosphere propagates without such directivity, the electron movements are constrained along the geomagnetic field, causing such directivity. The disturbance amplitudes are also influenced by the difference in the angle between the wavefront and the line of sight of the satellites. The waves propagated southward at an apparent speed of nearly 0.8 kilometers per second, which is the sound wave velocity in the lower part of the region of the ionosphere. Assuming the Chapman distribution or the altitude dependence of the electron density, the observed disturbances were reproduced assuming acoustic waves propagating upward and their interaction with geomagnetic fields. It was previously found that H-shaped signals are the signatures of explosive volcanoes, which also release massive energy to the atmosphere. The peak-to-peak amplitude of the disturbances reached nearly 2% of the background electrons, comparable to recently recorded volcanic explosions in the Japanese islands. These findings are recently published in Scientific Reports on February 2021. This was a collaborative research between National Institute of Technology, Rourkela, India, and Hokkaido University, Japan.